I'm here. Oh, man. Okay, for a sec, this thing did not load, and I was like... Well, fuck. Okay. Tonight's project is gonna be something... new. Or rather, something secret. Oh, I'm tired. So don't mind me if I'm not talking much, want to do something stereotypically, I want to do something stereotypically, God damn it. Let me look up a giant micro. Giant micro. Ah, yes. You guys can't see my screen right now, but I'm looking at, like, the most pixelated banner images possible. Like, they could have taken photos with, like, higher resolution. I can barely see anything. It's so bad. Oh my god, they have, like... Oh man, they have coronavirus themed face masks, but like they have an entire coronavirus themed face mask like pattern, and they don't have the they don't have the little AirPods case that's patterned by it. I'm disappointed. Let's see, do we have AirPods micro art case cover? It is decidedly inferior, but, oh man. I can't resist the thought of having like a coronavirus themed AirPods cover. Like, those of you listening in and are new, hi, I'm Ink. I qualify as a writing streamer. I do games. It all really depends on what kind of mood I'm in and how much I want to escape from, like, my day-to-day work, which, I'm a fourth-year biology student. Well, fourth-year microbiology student. And chemistry student, and I do COVID research on my spare time. That's why I'm like rambling on about like going on the giant microbe site and then getting sidetracked by their COVID products. Oh, hi Rhea, thank you for the follow. Welcome. For those of you curious as to why I'm looking up giant microbes, I'm actually supposed to be looking for a different virus that's not COVID, and I got sidetracked by my love/hate child at this point. Like I have a whole rant about COVID and why although I was excited to work on this project initially, I wish I got sacked with monkeypox. I actually really like orthopox viruses. I find them very interesting, and I find them far more interesting than beta coronaviruses, but you know, this is my project and this is basically my child now until it's done, and I hate it because nothing has worked so far. But yeah, what I'm actually supposed to be looking up is the giant microbes herpes plushie. Because this has to do with my plans for Valentine's Day. You see, what I'm working on right now is more or less the Valentine's illustration, and I want to include you know, being a virologist, I want to include a bit of my field in there, so yeah. That's why I'm on the giant microbes website looking for their herpes plushie, specifically their mononucleosis/Epstein-Barr virus plushie, which I found it, and I just found out that they have a giant 16-inch version, and I am not happy because man, I also have like a massive rant on this, but basically like my intro to virology class last year was a complete nightmare, and like we spent three whole weeks of lectures on the herpes family, So that's, you know, your standard cold sore, your other kind of cold sore, your myonucleosis, your what was the third kind of herpes again? I need to review my God. Your chicken poxes. Yes, cytomegalovirus, whatever the hell that is. And Kaposi sarcoma. Basically, there's a lot of herpes viruses, and they are infuriatingly complex. And the professor that taught that section, the 3 weeks long herpes boot camp, that's her specialty. So she expected us to like memorize every single protein and every single like replication method. And oh my God, I hated it so much. Like, all the other professors weren't nearly as bad. Well, I mean, there's a professor that taught our HIV unit. He focused a lot on HIV just because it is the most well-known member of the retrovirus family. But, like, he focused a lot on retroviruses. And just retroviruses are just, like, a difficult family of viruses in general to learn as, like, a wee little undergrad. So, that one was not fun, but like it wasn't entirely his fault. It was just the material that was hard. She just like, when I say the material was hard, I meant like the professor tried his best to dumb it down as much as he could, and everybody still had questions. But like for her, she didn't even try, and like, theoretically, it would have been very simple, but she just made us remember so much, like, detail that we wouldn't really need unless we were working her lab. Needless to say, she quickly made it onto my list of professors I refused to work with, purely because, oh my God, she made me hate the entire herpes family. And I'm just like, I have a list of like professors I refuse to work with, mostly because of like, hi Bo, welcome, thank you for the raid. I've been doing less drawing and more ranting about like my experiences in like intro to virology, because like what I'm supposed to be working on is like my Valentine's Day illustration. And like, basically I do work with viruses, and I thought, hey, it would be neat to like, you know, include something of my field in this illustration. And hi Starlight, hi, welcome. But like, anyway, I thought it would be neat to like include something from my field in the illustration. And so I went on the Giant Microbes website to like look for the mono plushie, and then I remembered that Mono is a member of the herpes family, and I started getting flashback to our 3-week herpes boot camp in intro to virology last year. And it was brutal, it was awful, and like all the other professors I refuse to work with are like purely because I've heard of like nightmare stories about their lab. Like, you know, one professor in the chemistry department, he's like, if you're not working like 24/7, you're slacking off, like that kind of toxic mentality. And then another professor, like his lab, actually this is like the HIV guy, the guy who taught like our HIV retrovirus unit, like his lab, he's all right, I guess, but like his lab is just so toxic that like the postdocs are yelling at each other from the other end of the hall, and it's just like, ooh, I don't want to be in that kind of environment. But like, the professor who taught the 3-week herpes boot camp, I said, no, I'm not working with her, purely because her 3 weeks of lecture made me hate the entire family. And I'm just like, no, I am never working with herpes viruses. I'm sorry, but like, no. And like, the only reason why I'm including my... that amount of toxicity is probably able to rival the toxicity of League of Legends. Now, I still maintain the stance that, like, League of Legends is probably far more toxic. Like, oh, I've seen my friends' League of Legends matches back when, like, I was in high school. Like, my high school somehow had, like, an actual esports team, and our league team was, like, somehow best in the state. And, like, although, like, you know, within the team, they were fine just because, like, you know, we were all friends and stuff. But, like, I've seen them play practice matches against, like, random people. And, oh my god, the things I've heard shouted on there kind of maybe definitely rival things I've heard on Xbox Live back in, you know, 2012. My school has an esports team. Our Call of Duty team ranked 4th or 5th in nationals. Wow, congratulations! Yeah, I don't know if, like, our esports team ever really made it to, oh, that was last year! Wow! I know for a fact that, like, my high school's esports team basically, like, fell apart after I and, like, basically most of the club leadership graduated, because they were, like, the only people that were, like, actually doing anything. And so I'm a senior now and I'm almost free. Well, yeah, high school's brutal. But, like, honestly, I don't know. If I'm being completely honest, I kind of miss high school just because I didn't have to worry about taxes and what to make myself for dinner, and I have to pay my utilities and my rent on time, and juggle my schoolwork on top of that. It's just, or, like, even in the summer when I was working full-time in the lab, it was just like, oh my god, I have to juggle on top of all that, plus, like, my actual work. It's just like, I miss high school when I had no responsibilities, when I could, like, actually spend most of my time dicking around playing video games, you know? Like, I would honestly give anything to, like, go back to that for, like, even just a week. Okay, actually, I should probably get to work. Like, this is what I came up with at first, but, like, I don't know. I kind of don't like the composition, you know? High school and other things in general have given me many problems physically and emotionally. Ah. My condolences, then. Okay. Anyways, I go to sleep now. I have school tomorrow. Well, good luck with your classes! Thankfully, tomorrow's my day off, but, like, unfortunately, by day off, I mean I stay home and I process data for my lab. And also, I have to bring my laptop to the university IT department, because somehow the school Wi-Fi hates me now. And, like, it happens at random. And usually it's fine, because I can switch the other school Wi-Fi, and then it's fine. But my lab is, like, off campus by, like, a decent bit, and I no longer have access to hospital Wi-Fi. Like, my lab is, like, actually located in a hospital, but, like, I no longer have access to, like, the hospital, like, staff Wi-Fi, and the guest Wi-Fi boots you off every 30 minutes. So I was stuck with no Wi-Fi on my computer, which is yay. Luckily, I have 2 classes instead of 4, which is normal, because 2 no blocks. Ah. Well, anyway, have a good sleep. Oh, man. But yeah, my thought with Valentine's Day was, like, more or less, major spoilers, but, like, you know, I take my slides from last year, and so I get in school late, learn English, go to next class about playing games, then go home. I wish I had class like that. Instead, I had calculus and history and English that I, two out of the three, I absolutely, gaming concepts. Like, I really wish I had a class like that back in high school. Like, I took all STEM classes and the required history classes and whatnot, and like any electives I had, I mostly took cooking and eventually graphic design. But we never had anything like that offered in my high school. The closest we had was like a game design class, but you had to take APCS in order as like a prerequisite. It was like, whoa. Anyways, I go now. Bye bye. Have fun with your drawing. Thank you. Have a good sleep. Okay. I think I have something that I like. I think. By sleep, I mean stay up all night. Ouch! you see, like, I usually have that kind of issue about, you know, staying up all night when I mean that, like, I want to sleep. Oh man, sometimes it's just like... Like, it honestly happened to me last night. Like, I wanted to sleep. I said, I'm gonna go to sleep at 11. I slept for an hour, and then I stayed up until... I stayed up until 5 in the morning. And I had to get to class at 10. And so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna nap for 2 hours. No, wait, nap for 3 hours, get up at 8. I have class at 10. Gonna have breakfast, gonna be productive. Yeah. And then the next thing I knew, I woke up and it was 10 already. And I was like, don't know. The thing with my university is like they do account for travel time, so it's like all my classes start 10 minutes later. I still arrived at class half an hour late because there was snow and ice from yesterday, and it had all compacted into, well, it had all been trampled into ice. It was kind of melting because today is warm. It was very slippery. So on my way to class, I was trying my best not to crack my head on the pavement and die. And like, given the fact that this is an unrecorded 2-hour class, I was like, you know what? Better I miss some than miss all of it. Yeah. That was very, very not fun, you know? Okay, actually, which one do you guys prefer? This one or this one? Because I personally prefer the second one. I don't know. What do you guys think? Just like the general pose. Like, all the other background stuff is like honestly gonna be the same. And also, if you guys like notice, like, if like the way that I draw it has sort of changed, it's because I did change into a screen tablet and like I draw a lot more like I do on paper now. I never really noticed how differently I draw like on paper versus like I draw with the old tablet. So it's like seeing how I pull lines slightly differently and like how my scribbles are like slightly looser is just like, ooh. And oh no, I just noticed I already chiseled my tip into my nib into quite a point. I should probably buy replacement nibs, like, right after I stream. Right after I end, yeah. Anyway. I'm gonna go with this one. Bye-bye! No. I did not just delete the wrong one. Nope. You did not see me. Okay, let's go start with like the actual sort of sketch. The one that is. Actually, anatomically correct. Okay, this is a bit too big. I just noticed that. It's okay, we can still correct it. Oh, no, no. Yo, Ivan. I am drawing something special for a certain holiday, where I will lecture the world on the wonders of herpes viruses, even though I do not like herpes viruses. And I don't mean a normal person disdain of herpes virus. I mean, I refuse to work with herpes based on one professor's 3-week lecture on the topic. Like, to quote Todd from Explosions and Fire, every good scientist needs a good grudge. Mine is against herpes viruses. The entire family. I hate them. Absolutely hate them. Wish they didn't exist. Because I believe that they serve to make, they only exist to make, undergraduate students miserable. What did they ever do to me? Hi, Baron! Hi, welcome! I was actually working on your model a bit, last night. I ended up kind of overhauling a bit of the hair rigging in the back, particularly, because I wasn't really satisfied with it, and I'm probably gonna have to redraw the entire beret just to, like, and rework it just to make it a bit easier to rig, because I realized that doing the beret as I did right now, like, there's a reason why everybody puts the beret square in the back of the head, and it's because it's so much easier to rig than something that is oblique. So, like, sorry if, like, that changes a bit. It's just I found that, like, there is no way that I could rig it without it looking really bad and making the entire face look worse. So forgive me if, like, that changes. I'm probably going to be actually working on stream on Saturday. Depends on how much my professor works me tomorrow and if I just end up wanting to play nothing but video games. Yep. No. Oh, absolutely no. You are not paying me extra for this. I've already taken an entire year. I'm not accepting more money. Like, at this point, it's just, I feel really bad already that, like, it's been a year and I haven't really made much progress because of, like, all the work that I've been doing, like, externally. And it's just... Yeah, it's just... I'm really... No. Trust me, I already feel really bad. And it's just, like, seeing people on Twitter saying, like, you... Like, all those art scams and stuff. And I'm just, like, I'm... Like, honestly, this entire situation has, like, made me really reconsider just, like, exactly how much time I actually have juggling schoolwork and, like, lab and whatnot. It's just, like, maybe I should just, like, not do commissions for a while and, like, actually focus on my school and stuff. Because that has already been low-key overwhelming. Like, I have another lab report doing... Oh, thank God, it's due the week after next week. I legitimately thought it was due this Tuesday. I totally understand. Trust me, my own job does that to me. Thank you. Thank you for being so understanding because, like, I see on my Twitter timeline that, like, honestly, there are a lot of people who would not be so, like, accommodating. It's just, I really don't deserve this. But, like, yeah, it's just... The life of a STEM undergraduate, you know, it's just... For a second, I thought my lab report was gonna be due next week, and I'm just like, oh my god, I don't even have the data processed, but at the same time, it's just like, I really can't do anything about that data because I tried to open it up earlier today, and it turns out the stuff that we just collected yesterday, the PDFs don't work, and the Excel data is more or less... stored in a giant it's literally just like values on like just like values on a it's literally just numbers and a whole lot of them, and it's just like, man, that is unusable, and the PDFs are also unusable. Hooray. So I have to literally go back into the lab and like beg a postdoc to let me in so I can get it on my flash drive and like pray that it works again. Like I actually have to like knock onto a grad student's like a lab's door and be like, please, I was in class yesterday and it turns out our data got corrupted, so I have to like go ahead and like try my best to fix it. Help. My grade depends on this. Please. I'm just a wee little undergrad, you know, have mercy on me. Oh my god. Wait, actually, I have a friend who might actually have access to there. Oh my god, I might not have to actually beg a grad student at random. Okay. But yeah, no, this is for a Valentine's Day voice pack, if you can call it. It's really more of a lecture, if I'm being completely honest. Like, I'm gonna be rehashing my professor's herpes lecture and condensing it into a nice, understandable, less bloated with science jargon thing for all to enjoy. So it's not exactly the most traditional Valentine's Day voice pack, you know? Like, I'm not gonna be saying like, oh yeah, you're gonna go on a date with me. We're gonna go ahead and go shopping and go have a nice meal. None of that. Like, I'm sorry. If you guys make me do one of those, I will probably never get it done because I will be dying laughing in the middle. It's just like, no, I actually can't. I actually can't do it. So yeah, you guys are getting a lecture at me instead. But yeah, this is more or less the bait illustration. Okay, this actually has to go down. And this. But yeah, if you guys see me looking down a lot more, it's because I changed tablets now, and it's just like, my back has been unshrimpified permanently because of how I have things set up, and I no longer am just like hunching. You guys can't see on there, but like before when I used to draw, I used to like literally just like have my I literally would used to like look like a giant shrimp, and now it's just like, you know, my back is straight because I forced myself to work with like the tablet all the way up by my face. And so it's just like, I no longer have to shrimp because it's literally being like held good posture. Let's go. Indeed. At the detriment of, looking like an absolute idiot in real life, but like, trust me, it works. Okay, never mind. This one actually looks a lot better. No, actually, if I... Oh, by the way, Ivan, I did take a listen at Suisei's newest album, and it's so good. I can't wait for my physical copy to like actually arrive. From like God knows where. It's on Spotify right now, by the way. Send pictures. I'll probably bring it to the club. Or actually, no. I'll probably post pictures of it to my Twitter. Let's just say that my son, Toaster, he got me into Suisei's music, and I have been hooked ever since, and I'm so sad that I missed the order window for Suisei's plushie, because now it's just like, you only see scalpers selling it and stuff, and like, I got into a bidding war in, on like Yahoo Auctions, and I was like, no, I'm not doing this. I'm not paying more than like double the price of the actual thing itself. No, they'll probably re-release it with like series 2, you know? They'll probably restock it. So
that's why I'm waiting. I love the Police Piccadilly song and the Jin song. I really need to look at the credits to see like who produced what, because like it doesn't show on Spotify. Like I need to look. Like I'm surprised they like got so many Vocaloid producers on the album, but like at the same time it's just like, no, it did. I'm not complaining because like those are all just like names I'm pretty familiar with from like back in my Vocaloid days. It's just like, you know, ha. Which, you know, hurts me a little to hear the children these days saying that, you know, the Vocaloids are from Prosecca. It's just like, no. They came from way before Prosecca. Prosecca just made them very mainstream. Well, a lot more mainstream than, like, Miku already was. Yeah, ISA also produced one. I think those are the three I recognized.
Yeah, I remember Jin from like Kageru days, and like that was actually legitimately the first Vocaloid album that like I have ever listened to. First ever Vocaloid song was actually Outer Science, and it's just like, wow, to think that was like almost a decade ago at this point.
Kageru Project is sick. My friend introduced it to me in high school. Wow. It was a fun week of diving into the MVs and lore. I hope you didn't watch the anime, because the anime is a disappointment. Like, they crammed, like, several, like, an entire light novel series, like, two albums of songs and MVs, and, like, even an entire manga series worth of like plot into 12 measly little episodes, and they cut out one of the most important roots in the thing. I tried really hard to watch it, but I lost motivation halfway through. Good, because I watched it all the way through and I was so pissed at the end. And I was like, bruh. No, it was absolutely a cop-out ending if you know the entire plot. And like, for those of you who don't, sorry for major spoilers. Just like, you know, plug in your ears and like, you know, sing la 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 if you don't want to hear. But like, spoiler alert, like, the entirety of like Kageru Project is like based on, basically if you die on August 13th, if you like die with something else, like one of the things gets sacrificed and you come back with like, you know, cool snake powers and stuff, and like it all started with like this one Medusa lady who fell in love with a man and had little God, what was her name again? Little Mary. Outer Science, the best song, don't at me, lol. But like anyway, yeah, basically like, you know, they had little Mary, and like, you know, the Medusa lady was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna make our own little world and we'll be a happy family, and then, you know, the man dies. It's probably okay for you to hear this, because, like, I think you did a deep dive into the lore, but, like, you know, I'm basically, like, spoiling the main plot of, like, the overarching story, and then I'm gonna get into the anime ending, which, honestly, the anime ending isn't exactly a spoiler. Like, please listen to what I say about the anime ending, because it is absolutely awful and you should not finish it. But anyway, yeah, basically, like, you know, Snake Lady got very sad that her husband died, and so she basically sealed herself into, like, that realm. And basically, if you die on August 13th or August 20 something, or just someday in August, basically, if you die with, like, another thing, like, only one of you makes it out, and, like, the Snake Lady blesses you with, like, you know, snake powers and stuff. And so, like, yeah, there's a group of kids who end up getting that stuff and blah blah blah. And, like, basically Mary has, like, this whole power where she can basically, like, rewind time and do the whole Groundhog Day loop thing. So, like, this one guy who ended up with snake powers, like, the snake possessing him and providing his powers basically, like, you know, wants to essentially keep itself alive by perpetually, you know, perpetually doing a time loop thing. If I remember correctly, this was, like, I did the whole lore deep dive a decade ago, so my memory's kind of rusty, but, like, basically the gist of it is, the time loop snake basically wanted to keep himself alive and basically kept on killing everybody and forcing Mary to reset things. Yay! And so, like, you know, basically, like, you learn of this happening in, like, the light novels and the manga and what is collectively called by the fandom and probably officially as, like, Root XX, which is basically you actually see everybody getting killed and Mary having to reset the world. And then Shintaro, the main character, he dies and comes back with, like, you know, essentially the power to remember all past loops and finally breaks it. So, like, that's basically the whole plot. The anime skips the entirety of everybody dying and goes directly to the yay, everybody's saved. I was just like, bruh. You missed one of the most important story beats. Like, you cut out a whole entire plot. Higurashi with more steps then? Yeah. But Vocaloid. Keep in mind, this was, like, back when I, like, first discovered anime, I didn't know what Higurashi was. So, I was like, ah, and then I saw the anime, I was like, ah. I wanted to play Higurashi, but my mom would not let me because she's like, oh, you're too young, it's too bloody. And then I forgot. Maybe I'll play it on stream one of these days. I don't know. Like, yeah, overall, it's a very fun Vocaloid project, and the anime absolutely did not do it justice. So yeah, that was my entire rant about the Kageru Days anime and why it's bad and why nobody should watch it and just read the light novels or even somebody's summary of the entire thing. Like, it, anything but the anime. Anything but the anime. I read the manga but skipped the, like, novel because reading takes too long. That's why I say just, like, read somebody's summary of it. It's functionally the same thing. I think I actually read somebody's summary. And that's how I know all this. Actually, do I want my hair down or do I want it up in a ponytail? Because, like, this is supposed to be, like, you know, bait. You expect a hot date with a doctor? No. It's a herpes lecture. Which, you know, yeah, I'm definitely gonna have fun recording this, but I'm not gonna have fun with the research. Like I said, herpes viruses are my old enemy, and I don't like them. Purely because, you know, professor teaching them. Not good. Not good at all. Actually, I should probably harass my friend Saiken for, like, a white coat reference. Okay, so it's 12:53 in the morning. 7 more minutes and I will absolutely go to bed because, like I said, I gotta wake up early tomorrow. I gotta go ahead and harass University IT, and then I gotta go ahead and retrieve my data because boohoo. PDFs do not work. Yeah. what should I wear underneath? Like, I feel like I should give myself pink scrubs, but you know, that could be a little bit too cliche. Or I could just, you know, give myself a classical. Hi, shark. Unfortunately, you're a bit like I'm contending for minutes. Yeah, like I said earlier that I'm gonna end at 1 a.m. because I need to wake up early tomorrow, call myself to the university IT desk, and get my Wi-Fi situation sorted out, and then I gotta go ahead and go down to the chem labs and retrieve my data, because the one that my TA uploaded has like corrupted PDFs, and I basically have to re-export them and pray that they work. It's just, you know, overall, I'm just sad. It hard work. And then, of course, it's just a long day of wrangling Excel afterwards in the comfort of my own home. But yeah, just a short description of, like, the project that I'm working on right now. This is basically gonna be my Valentine's Day illustration, and it comes with a voice pack where instead of it being like, you know, hot doctor ASMR, it's gonna be me giving an entire lecture on herpes viruses, specifically Epstein-Barr virus. It's gonna be great. And by great, I mean I'm probably gonna be seething the entire time because I hate herpes viruses, thanks to this one professor who taught the unit last year and spent 3 whole weeks on it. It was probably the 3 worst weeks of my life. So I'm basically going to be condensing her slides into a nice, easily understandable 10-minute lecture for the general public to enjoy. All with this wonderful extra baity thumbnail, because why the fuck not? But yeah, this is my sense of humor, essentially. Okay. So how do I do this hand thing? Okay. Then I probably need to like actually hold a stethoscope or something in order for like this to work. Or like trace my hand again. Because this ain't it. But yeah, I hope you guys look forward to it. And yeah, it's gonna be free and on YouTube because free things are nice. So maybe I'll offer like, maybe I'll offer like a 4K wallpaper version of this illustration on my coffee. But like, no, this is only 1080p. I should. Once I'm done with the sketch, I'll boost the resolution. Yeah. And then, do I want to include my horns or not? Nah. This one's gonna be no horns. And nope. It's 1:02, which you guys know what that means. It's sleep time. And with that, good night everybody. I'll see you guys on Saturday. I'll be doing a rigging stream, and depending on how that goes, I might also be doing a bit of ode art for Alhitham Mains and another friend's stuff. Yeah. With that, I bid you guys good night.